Hello guys, welcome back to another episode of this Nationalist China Let's Play. In the last episode we were trying to close a very important pocket. A pocket where we have around 20 Japanese divisions, more or less. We have 5, 6, 7, 8, 9... Well, we have, along with that quarters, we have 21 divisions, 21 units here. And despite being encircled for quite a long time now, they have no supply problems. But the ones encircling them, or in other words me, I'm having huge supply problems. So I'm also being attacked here. This is going to collapse unless this division gets there in time, but it's also out of supplies, so this is going to be a very close call. We'll see what happens. In the north they seem to be doomed. Simple militia are winning the battles because they are out of supplies. If I manage to keep these guys from advancing north, they will take a huge blow by losing all these divisions. But I really, really want to destroy these guys. Let's see what happens. According to this guy will arrive on this province. That's the only last hope for these divisions. On August 6th, it's too much time. They were alive there before of that, I'm sure. So I'm going to try to strategic redeploy it there. Hopefully I will arrive before that. And if I manage to do that, I'm confident that we will close this pocket, because I have another two divisions here and several divisions in this province that will continue attacking them. Sooner or later they will be out of supplies. Lovely. Yeah, that's why I didn't want to strategically redeploy them. Oh crap. Okay, one of them is still not in strategical. Okay, forget it, I'm going to lose this province here. That's granted, and they will escape. Let's see what happens. Oh wait, I can attack. I can attack with this guy. Yeah, I'm gonna pin them down. Give my divisions enough time to arrive there. It worked. So these guys in the pocket are screwed unless I get out of supplies. They are already losing divisions. Each one that goes out of war is dead. So let me reorganize these as much as possible. So what we have here, this division is the most exposed. So these two guys are coming here. You remain there. I need divisions down here as soon as possible. I'm gonna take a chance and strategically deploy them. Just hold on. Okay, these guys are done. At least I hope so. After this attack, I will have more divisions to keep harassing them. Hours for the next attack. Hopefully they will be suffering from lack of supplies already. These guys are holding on bravely. Only military police and militia, remember? Pretty crappy units. They're on a mountain. Cannot survive this. Still no lack of supplies. Well, I don't need these divisions, all these divisions here, so it's a good idea to attack them from only one province. Not anymore, because they only have a stacking penalty of 7. It means that we have destroyed lots of units already. So let's help them. Yeah, the lack of supplies is killing me. Not worth it. Go back. Stay there. Hope this guy can arrive before this one. Okay, I need to reorganize these divisions. Let's have a look what's going on here. Gee. Still only minus 23 of lack of supplies. Awesome. Unbelievable. Okay, I need these guys down here. I need every infantry division available to be near Korea. Okay, we already have 140 of officers, so time to continue. Well, not yet. Train more spies. And this is working out. They still don't have lack of supplies. My divisions are with lack of supplies, but they don't. They aren't. But they are going to be defeated. They can't hold out for much longer. Because my units are, despite all the problems, my units are much better than theirs. Then they're encircled. Was being attacked. Yeah, I have a division. Crap. Lack of supplies, damn it. Looks like I'm the one encircled, not them. Okay, I need those guys for suppression, or I will be having a nasty surprise. Around here, at least. Supplies. help them. Come on, break those guys. Yeah. I'm the one being broken. These guys are losing organization. Well, at least if they don't get 2% supplies, so they probably been 0%, so they are losing organization. Lovely. Okay. I won't worry more with these guys. They almost are a zero organization, so they will be defeated soon. I'm worried with this now. This guy is taking forever to reach this province. I need to take this back, and this also. Hopefully these guys won't run out of supplies. Come down here. Oh, lovely. The headquarters are escaping. Okay, I'm gonna, if they are on headquarters, they should be. I'm going to strategically redeploy our headquarters around. Come down here. Come on. Yeah, lack of supplies again. I support his attack, and I'm going to be attacked across the river. Oops, not a good idea, no orc. Well, I'm in a lot of trouble. because of the S words, supplies. And wrecked infrastructure. Okay, I'm gonna try to keep them off bay by keeping these divisions here. You go back there. You go here and you go there. Too late, guys. Too late to save them. Okay, the militia apparently is doing well, but not fast enough. Okay, it's time to reorganize my hub because of supplies. Some divisions are out of range, so I'm gonna stop recording here. Hello guys, I'm back. I stopped recording because I wanted to reorganize my hub because some divisions are out of at quarter radio range, but I quickly abandoned that idea because it won't make much difference. As you can see, we have 0.07 supplies here, 0.62, 0 supplies, 6 supplies for all these divisions, which are all out of organization due to lack of supplies, 0.81 supplies, and so on. You get 0 supplies here, so supply doesn't reach here. If some of these divisions have supply, it's because of these nearby ports, because somehow the supply system with a minus 100% supply to output, 50% because of occupation, when we conquer an enemy province, we immediately receive a minus 50% of supply to output in that province, and in very hard, like I said, we have a minus another minus 50% to output, and as you can see here, the infrastructure is badly damaged. Another problem in low infra areas is that anything that is damaged takes a long time to repair, so this is not quite a low infra, but it's not great, so this will take a long time to repair. What I mean is that I'm in a desperate situation. I will be going nowhere fast. All these divisions will, no matter what I do, they will get out of organization due to lack of supplies, and the Japanese will eventually advance north. So I have a few options left. One of them is to actually sign a peace treaty. The Japanese are accept that, but I won't do it. So why is this so important, a peace treaty with the Japanese? Because it would solve my supply situation. I would have to wait around a few months, around 3 months, more give or take, to be able to declare war on them again. I'm not quite sure, it's around 2 to 3 months. Usually when I'm at war, I never sign a peace treaty, so it's war to the end. So I'm not going to change now. I'm going to continue this war, but like I was saying, since this is a tutorial, LP towards teaching something about this game, if I sign a peace treaty with Japan, I would annex all these provinces. All the provinces that are currently under my control will become cores of the Nationalist China. So I would get rid of that minus 50% supply draw output. And another very important thing is that all provinces with IC would produce produce supplies immediately. So we have here one province with 6 IC. This province will since Nationalist China has a claim on it, once it is annexed by Nationalist China, it will become a core. So supplies are deployed in at the level of cores. As you can see here, if I put the slider to supplies, only to supplies, for example, of course I would take care of consumer goods and reinforcement and all, but if I put the supply all the way to the slider all the way to produce supplies, a pretty big huge amount of supplies would be deployed here. So these two provinces here would be enough to supply, and this one here would be enough to supply my troops here. So the Japanese would be doomed, because not only I would get rid of the minus 50% supply to output of occupation, I would also have a source of supplies right here in the front lines. But like I said, I will do my best not to do that. So that leaves me only another option. I don't see any other option. I have a transport, like I did in the other game, in the other episode. I'm going to take a chance and use my transport to try to capture this port here. This one was not garrisoned. I'm hoping that this one is also not garrisoned. So this is a desperate attempt. My plan is the following. I would capture this port, and I will try to bring enough divisions one by one, because unfortunately I only have one transport. This was bad planning on my behalf, because I wanted to attack these guys so early that I didn't foresee the supply situation becoming so bad. In my defense, I must say that I wasn't expecting the Japanese to join the Axis so soon. I had a kind of hope that I would have a few months to annex Manchukuo, but unfortunately that didn't happen. So I'm going to join immediately the Axis, so Manchukuo went into exile, and I'm now at the lack of a better word, in a pretty shitty situation, very desperate. So desperate times require desperate measures. I'm going to try to they have garrisons here, probably they may have a garrison here or some kind of infantry, don't know. I'm going to use my planes to find out, and I will try to capture this port and give the Japanese a bit of my of what's hurting me, lack of supplies. Because if I manage to capture this port and also this one, I will have enough supply to supply something around 4 cores of infantry here. Should be enough to hold this. Also, because most of the Japanese army is north of this line, they are trapped here and they are over here. Many of these divisions probably still haven't regained organization due to the poor supplies, poor infrastructure. So hopefully that's the case. So this will be our time is already up, but I think I'm going to play I'm going to make this a longer episode, because I really want to see if my plan works. So like I said, I'm just adjusting the timer. I'm going to use my planes to scout this area, but I am already bringing divisions. Look at this, all these divisions without organization. It's terrible. So I'm going to, let me see, we have three here with our organization. I'm going to strategically redeploy them to the nearest starboard, which is here. Don't know why they don't obey me. What the heck? Okay, they now seem to care. This one is coming here also. Okay, first five divisions. I'm also detaching all these divisions with bad organization, because if I'm lucky and manage to capture that port, if they're supplied, they will regain organization faster. Okay, but I'm gonna need more divisions. I have to take them down fast. So okay, they are heavy. 14 divisions. I'm gonna need more if I want to be successful. I'm gonna some divisions with organization problems, because I don't want this front to collapse. So I better leave some with organization here. This guy is coming here too. This guy doesn't have work, is coming here also. What I'm going to do next, the AI is good too for some things, but bad at others. I'm going to, if this works, I will be focusing here. I don't want to have to macromanage the divisions over here. The AI is pretty good at removing divisions from the front if they are out of organization, bringing them back and replacing it with divisions that have organization. So what I'm going to do is to create a front for this headquarter. I already did it. Here it is. Let me just reclaim this to the manual control headquarter. So what I'm going to do is to automate this theater in prepare stance. So in prepare stance, it will try to deploy, the theater will do its best to hold this line, but won't attack. So I will be free to concentrate my efforts in trying to cut off the Japanese. So the AI sometimes can be useful. I'm gonna use it now. So I'm gonna bring the transport here. I'm going to do a recon over here. Don't know if my fighter has range to reach there. Probably. No, it doesn't. So I better not tip them off. I'm going to do a recon over here. Probably I can see it. Air superiority. Let me see if I can see something. Oh, by the way, also to add a look at production queue, and I was prioritizing infrastructure, but that's a bad idea. We won't have time to build these. It will go to the bottom of the queue because the first batch will be ready by April 6. Look at the date. We are in August of 1938. We have around 8 months waiting. We will be doomed by then. Then the infrastructure still has to repair, and it will take forever. So it won't make much difference. We either sign a peace treaty or this plan succeeds. If this plan doesn't succeed, we will have to sign a peace treaty or the Japanese will steamroll us because we are out of organization. So enough talking, let's proceed. So I gave priority to the CLs and to the divisions, to militia divisions especially, also to those with suppression. I also need convoys because I only have 19. So I'm going to put this into prioritizing upgrades, like I almost always do. No luck. Yeah, one brigade. They have some kind of navy there, and one brigade. Only one unit, so my navy should be able to handle it, hopefully. And they have units here, but since they are in the rear, they probably are out of organization. We will see. So we are in trouble here. Probably not, these guys should be able to handle these guys because they're almost out of work. Okay, I'll let it. So it's all or nothing again. This is only happening because I wanted to conquer the Japanese as soon as possible, and because I'm playing it very hard. At normal I would have supply problems probably, but not as many as I'm having now. As you can see, currently this headquarters has 355,000 troops under his command. I doubt that the Chinese could not supply this many these troops. So with the divisions I detached, this would make around 400k, give or take. So let's see if I'm lucky. Okay, I'm not gonna wait more. There is a perfectly good division here. I'm going to detach it. Let's hope this works or I am screwed. Okay, we have won almost win. We have won the battle. Great. Okay. Man, this is going to be very risky. If these guys have org, I'm screwed. I'm gonna lose a division. If I don't do this, I'm screwed anyway, so... Oh, by the way, we already have enough spies. It's time to continue our research. Let me see. I'm going to try, since we have many spies now, I'm going to shift the priority to try to kill these spies. Same thing here, if I can lower this, then we'll switch everything to tech. Okay. More divisions will arrive here, so... Here goes nothing. No order. Go there. If the Japanese Navy, well, apparently they have one here, maybe a submarine or something. But if the Japanese decide to intervene, either by land or by sea, I'm screwed. If I had 40 transports or 5, I could land 5 divisions at once and they would not be able to stop me. Unless they sunk all of them, of course. By the way, let me check technology. Yeah, I need to start researching these techs. They are very important. All refining, because now we are starting to build lots of cruisers, and we need fuel and coal to oil. I'm going to research them all, but those two will have priority. So let's see how this goes. Fingers are crossed. The Japanese keep attacking. Look at this. Zero supplies, 0.15. Okay, I'm already... Oh shit. The Japanese the Japanese CVs probably aren't far. Here they are. Damn it. They have to hold. Okay, I've lost. I just hope I don't lose my transport. I don't care about the cruisers, they're all... They're old. They will be a liability in the new Navy. But I really need these transports. Come on, just a few more minutes, seconds. Okay. Tactile 4, going to run. That one was close. I hope I don't get attacked. Jesus, so many nice ships here. Okay, here goes nothing. Okay, we now are ahead of time in artillery. That's great. Let's see how things are going here, if the militia is... Yeah. Okay, I'm attacking and I'm not being attacked. This single garrison brigade is no match for me. Oh shit, I'm already being attacked. Range. Okay, this division is probably doomed. Okay, I'm going to bomb this garrison to see if I can make it fold faster. I'm under the attack of a single division. What I'm going to do? Good question. Another desperate. I don't care. Maybe the garrison will fall immediately. It did. Hours. This guy's a defensive leader, he has a good chance of holding. If these guys come out of port, I'm doomed. Come on. Okay, I'm screwed. No, not yet. Well, if I manage to do this, I promise that I will pay dearly for their mistake. Okay, it's done. Time to run away. We have more divisions. I must pick them up. You can all come here. Okay, these guys don't need fuel. Gonna lose this division or what? I'm telling it to retreat and it doesn't retreat, so it's fighting to the death. Okay, I'm going to bring these guys to the, because they are almost destroyed. I don't want that. It's an old plane, but I still need it. Let's see what happens. I will, however, put this fighter here to try to find out what's going on here. If there are hostile navies here. Okay, I'm gonna try to help this guy. Not needily, he will eventually win. Okay, no time to lose, gonna pick more guys. How we're doing here? I'm gonna create a core here to save supplies and an army to give them an higher organization level 3. I hope I don't get intercepted. No navy here. Okay, I need a few more guys to push towards this port. E1, great. No Japanese navy here, at least my fighter tells me that. Let me check production. I really need to start gaining cruiser practicals. These guys are a liability also, but I need the practicals. Okay guys, this episode has reached, the time is up for today. I hope you have enjoyed this. Things are starting to finally look good, despite their breaking through here, but if I play this right, they will soon be out of supplies. So, I hope you have enjoyed it. Hope to see you soon. Take care.